In this demo, I'm going to show the basic deployment of a component and how we view the APIs that that component exposes. Now, when we talk about an ODA component, we use this picture on the left. The implementation of that is actually a YAML definition of all the different metadata in this structured format, which is following a Kubernetes standard. And you see this is a component within the oda.tinform.org namespace. This example is a product catalog and has a core function where it's exposing APIs. In this case, it's exposing the product catalog and exposing the standard tinform open API for a product catalog. And so every part of the picture on the left is represented as metadata in this YAML definition on the right. When I go and deploy component, I can deploy it using a simple command line. I'm using the Helm package manager. So I say Helm install and give this instance of a component a unique name. And then I've got the product catalog. And here I've got that same YAML definition. Takes just a few seconds to deploy. And the good thing, because we're following the Kubernetes standard, it means that my component becomes a first-class citizen in the Kubernetes ecosystem. So I can use any of these standard Kubernetes tools to go and look at that component. So I can say kubectl, which is the Kubernetes command line tool, get components.oda.tinform.org, and this will show details about my component. And you can see saying that's the name. It's still, the deployment is still in progress, but it's already telling me some detail about what APIs it's exposing. Now I can use any one of the Kubernetes tools, and the tinform Open Digital Lab is actually managed using Rancher. And Rancher is also extending Kubernetes. And so I go into the Cluster Explorer in Rancher at that cluster. It comes under the More Resources. This is where all the custom definitions are stored. Go into More Resources. There's an oda.tinform.org space. And if I click on there, there's a components custom resource. You see here's my component, it's still in progress of being deployed. And the component can also generate or create API resources. And you see now the deployment is complete. And if I click here, this shows the APIs that that component has created. And you can see there's a metrics API, which is part of the management interface. There's a party role API, which is part of the security. And there's the product catalog API, which is the core function for this component. And I'm going to have a look inside these resources. And if I go and have a look inside, I'm just going to simplify this a bit. Now, every Kubernetes resource has a metadata, a spec, and a status part of it. The metadata has a name and a label and things like that. The spec shows the intent of this resource. So what's the target? And this is what you define in your YAML definition. So in this case, I'm looking at the party role API, and my intent was to expose an open API with a specification, which is the tinform standard specification for 669 party role. And it's giving some details about there's a microservices implementing this, and the API will appear at a certain path within it, and there's a nice docs section where a developer can have a developer view of this API. So that's the target. And then Kubernetes, it constantly looks to make sure that the implementation matches the target. And it gives an update of the status of that in the status section. So here, it's saying this API status, it's saying, actually, I've chosen where I'm going to expose the API, and it's giving me a full path. So you see in this spec, we didn't know exactly where it's going to expose. We only knew the end of the path. But here it's saying, actually, I've exposed it using Istio as an ingress gateway. And here is exactly where I can find that developer UI for my API. And then give me some other details about it. So it's giving me details about the port and about, for example, it's saying the implementation is ready. So it's telling me the self-test is working and the implementation for that is ready. So I go and open a browser and look at that developer UI. So this is the standard Swagger developer front end of that API. And for example, I can go and have a look and say, so this is a party role API, it's part of the security, and go and say, a list will find all the party role objects. Now this component's just been deployed, so it should just be the bootstrap role, and I can actually try it out. So this will actually call the open API of my component, and you can see here it's getting a response saying, yes, there is one resource in this party role, it's the admin resource, which is, this is the bootstrap role that gets deployed as part of the component. So that's a simple demonstration of deploying a component and examining the custom resources and seeing an API exposed.